Hello everyone. Now our next experiment is based on inheritance. Let's see first the definition of the inheritance. After that we will go back to our program. Okay. Now the inheritance is a very important concept in object-oriented programming language. Inheritance in Java is a mechanism in which one object acquires all the properties and behaviors of a parent object. The idea behind the inheritance is that you can create the new classes that are built upon existing classes. When you inherit from an existing class, you can reuse methods and fields of the parent class. And you can also add the new methods and the fields in your current class. Inheritance represents the is-a relationship, which is also known as a parent-child relationship. Because of inheritance, we can reuse the code, and it is one of the most important use of inheritance, that is advantage of the inheritance. Next, in Java, a class that is inherited is called a superclass, and the class that does the inheriting is called a subclass. And this is all about the concept of the inheritance. Now let's see in our program. Here first, a class named as A is created, which is a superclass. And in this class, the two variables I and J of type integer are declared. Then one method showIJ is defined. In that method, the variables of I and J are displayed by using the simple println statement. Next, a class B. Class B is created, which is a superclass of, which is a subclass of superclass A. So we can say that B is a subclass of superclass A, and this relationship can be denoted by using the keyword extends. So you can see here extends keyword. In the subclass B, there is a one variable k of type integer is declared, and one method, that is show k, is defined. In that method, the value of the k variable is displayed by using the println statement. Next, another method, that is sum, is also defined in subclass B. In that method, the sum of the three variables I, J, and K is displayed. Now see in the statement of the println. So as we have already studied about inheritance, that is subclass inherits all the instance variables and methods defined by the superclass and adds its own unique elements. That's why here in the sum method, subclass I and J variables can be referred to directly as if they were part of B. Next, inheritance class is created, and in the main inheritance class is created, and in the main method, the object of superclass A, that is super OB, is created, and sub OB is the object of the subclass B. Next, by using the object of the superclass, the values are assigned to the variables I and J. And this is a simple println statement to display a message. Next, by using the object, after that, by using this object, the showIJ method is called here to display the values of the I and J. Then by using the subclass object, the values are assigned to the variables I, J, and K. So here, after that method, the showIJ is called. Now concentrate on this method. The showIJ method is defined in the superclass A, but still the subclass can call this method showIJ, and also it can also access the variables I and J. because the subclass B inherits all the members of its superclass A. Next, it is calling its own method, that is showK. ShowK here, and here there is a simple println statement. And after that, the sum method is called. Sum method is called to display the sum of the three variables, that is I, J, and K variables. So here the end of the program. Now to see the output, run the file. Now in the output window, see the output. First, contents of the superclass I and J, contents of the subclass I and J variables, and K is also its own variable of the subclass. Then sum of the three variables I, J, K, which is displayed here, 24. Okay, thank you.